This is the battlefield for our game of speed and strategy. These are the letters which lead to victory on Blockbusters! And here's the star of Blockbusters, Bill Pellet!
Hello there. Hi there, you nice. Hi, thank you. Thank you very much. Hello there, players. I call you players because it's a feminine dance with me. Thank you. Thank you, and welcome to Blockbusters. You know how this game works. We have a family pair. Family pair is pitted against a solo player. We play two games. That constitutes a match, and the side first to win two games, and it's $500 a game, and $1,000 gets a chance to go to the Blockbuster board, Gold Rush board, for $5,000. Well, now, let me tell you about our solo player here. His name is John Hatton. He's a psychologist. He's been up to that board, I imagine. Well, I won't tell you how much because I'm saving how much he won his last. And so far, he's won of his very own, I guess he'll have to split it with his family, $30,000. Welcome back, John. We haven't heard much about John Hatton personally for the last day or so, so what would you care to tell us that's new or different, or you want to...
Well, okay. I still have the same wife and the same three kids.
Good, good.
And if it doesn't sound too corny, I've gone to school and worked hard all my life, and so has my wife, Joan. And like so many people, we've never had just a whole lot of funny money drop into your lap.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, it's just an incredible experience.
Certainly is. I tell you, I can't help wondering how you knew that we pay in funny money around here. But it's been happening to me for more years than I care to. The family pair here are, it's a father and daughter team, Jimmy Carter and his daughter, Cindy Carter. Welcome, you two. Good to have you here. What's new with you, Jimmy?
Well, Bill, I think I found out who those two Democrats were down in Orange County.
Oh, did you? You know them personally, huh? And your daughter, Cindy. Hi, Cindy.
Hi.
Tell us about you.
Oh, I go to school full-time, and I'm just happy to be here.
Well, happy to have you. Now, let's see. When time was called the other day, we were right in the middle of game one, so we did not have a winner yet. We will put the setup on our board exactly where as it was. You see, John... It's up to him to score top to bottom, to connect top to bottom with the red. He already had three correct answers indicated by those three red boxes. And our family pair, Jimmy and Cindy, had one right answer, and that's the white box over there. Family pair works across the board from left to right. Solo player works top to bottom. Now, when time was called, I think you had just given me a correct answer. Am I right about that? Was it Jimmy who had given me? Jimmy had given me the correct answer. So he got in there for the first time. He has that white block you see in the lower left. So now I ask you, Jimmy, where do you want to go?
I think I'm going to go with the W.
With the letter W. Okay. Now, all the answers begin with the letters indicated. So this is a W question, which means the answer begins with a W. Okay, so John, Jimmy, Cindy, as soon as you think you know the answer, hit the button. I stop talking. Here you go. Question coming, W. What W fell when Joshua blew? Yes, Jimmy?
Wall.
Blew his horn at Jericho. Wall is the answer. You got another one, Jimmy. Now where, Jimmy?
Z.
Letter Z. I see what you're going to do. You're going to make your connection over there without giving John a chance to win the game by stopping you. Question coming. Answer starts with Z. Everybody ready? What Z was the doctor who... Yes, John?
Zhivago.
No. I now repeat the question. Either Jimmy or Cindy may answer. What Z was the doctor who took Ben Casey under his wing? Either of you know that? Time. Answer, Zorba. Dr. Zorba. Goes back a little way. Okay, we stay with the Z's now because that was chosen. I was going to say I didn't have a Z, but here's a Z right here. Answer starts with a Z. Ready to go again. What Z is a flat stringed... John?
Zither.
Instrument. Zither is the answer. Okay, good anticipated. All right, John, where do you want to go?
R, please,
Bill. I had a feeling you were coming over there. Here we are at that spot where if John comes up with the right answer, he will have won game one of this match. Jimmy and Cindy are in there to block. As soon as either any of you think you know it, hit the button. Question coming. for the game as far as John Hatton's concerned. What R is the family of turtles, dinosaurs, Cindy?
Reptiles.
Reptiles is right. And lizards, I was going to say.
Let's see, go
they threw the block at you, John. Where to, Cindy?
A, please.
The letter A. Okay. A question. Everybody ready? What A was a little rascal with a colic? Cindy.
Alfalfa.
Right. White again. Family pair. Family pair connects left to right. Where to, Cindy?
E, please.
Letter E. Does not quite make the connection, but it sure gets you close. Question coming. What E is the beer that uses the slogan, Jimmy?
Erlinger.
Taste the moment. Right. Erlinger is the answer. I thought that was your brother Billy with that answer, Jimmy. Where to?
I'm going to go for the N.
All right, that's the fateful letter, because that's going to do it for somebody. If Cindy and Jimmy get this one, they win by connecting side to side. If John gets it, he wins by connecting top to bottom. So it's a big one. First game of this match. Question, answer begins with an N. What N is America's capital of country music? John.
Nelson.
No. Hang on now, Jimmy and Cindy. I repeat it for you. Now, Jimmy, you're the captain. You'll decide who answers. What N is America's capital of country music? One answer only. Jimmy for the game.
Nashville.
That's right. Your family pair is one. There it is. Pretty good. Okay, that's game one. So that means that Jimmy and Cindy, you now pick up $500 no matter what happens. That's game one. We will now go on to game two. So Jimmy and Cindy trying to win this one in order to get a chance at the Gold Rush and $5,000. John trying to win to stay in contention. Oh, yeah, we got you in suspense? Good, we want to keep you there for just a moment while we show you these things by force. Okay. We're back here now for game two. John Hatton has to win this one in order to stay in. John's done very well. He's won five in a row, five matches. And Cindy and Jimmy, your work's cut out for you. However, you have the all-important lead now. So we're going to start this game from scratch, and the first letter is going to be B. Answer will begin with the B. You see the B flashing on the board. Question coming. Good luck to everybody. It's a big one. What B was the nickname of Theodore Cleaver? Yes, Cindy.
Beaver.
You're right. Beaver is it. I didn't know that. I did. I missed that along
the
line.
Show.
I didn't know that, Cindy. I'm glad you. Where do you want to go, Cindy?
S, please.
Letter S. Okay. Question coming. Everybody ready? What S was James Michener's bestseller about an interracial marriage? John?
Sayonara.
In post-war Japan. Sayonara is right. Red's on there. Where to, John?
J, please, Bill.
Letter J. Question coming. Answer begins with J. Everybody ready? What J is Mrs. David Eisenhower? John. Time. Repeat it now for the Carters. What J is Mrs. David Eisenhower? Which of you would like to answer that? Jimmy, you're the captain. Someone, go ahead.
Jim?
Nope. Julie. J-U-L-I-E. G-U-L-I-E. Okay, we stay with the J's now. We still come up with another J question. Everybody ready? Oh, I like this. What J went up the hill? Jimmy?
Jack.
I now repeat it for John.
Oh, my. That's
what J went up the hill with Jack?
Jill.
By the process of elimination. That was a good try, Jimmy.
Jill.
Was a good try, Jimmy.
Yep.
There's one or two. Well, you had a 50-50 chance. Where do we stand? Red has two toward connecting top to bottom and tying the game. Where to, John?
D, please, Bill.
Letter D. Coming up. Ready? What D are Canada's famous... Yes, Jimmy.
Dion.
Quintuplet sisters or quintuplet sisters. Dion is right. Lock in there for white. Where to, Jimmy?
L.
Letter L. Okay. Question coming. What L did Henry Higgins make? John. I repeat it now for Jimmy or Cindy. What L did Henry Higgins make out of Eliza Doolittle? Which of you? Either of you. Any of you. You
sausages.
Had your hand, huh?
Sausage?
No.
I was thinking.
It's a heck of an idea for another musical, though. Yeah. The L that Henry Higgins made out of Eliza Doolittle was Lady. You were thinking of Henry Ford, who made a sausage out of Lizzie back in the old days. Well, nothing ventured, nothing ground, so we go on now. It's another L question. Other L question. Everybody, now we'll settle down because it's important to you three folks. Take a deep breath. L question coming. What L had the world's first subway? John.
London.
London is the right answer, John. You're on the board again. Where to, John? Oh, John, hold before you pick. I'll pause here because we have to get these things done. It has to do with business affairs or something. Don't go too far away.
What if you...
Okay, we're midway in game two of this match. Cindy and Jimmy won the first one, and John's fighting to stay in. John has three right answers, as you see, no connection yet. And family pair Cindy and Jimmy have two, no connection yet. John, you answered correctly last time. Where would you like to go?
Oh, please, Bill.
Letter O. Okay. Everybody ready now. Hit the button as soon as you think you know. Question. What O is Anne Margaret's maiden name? Time. Olson. Anne Margaret Olson. Okay. We stay right with the O's there and come up with another one. Everybody ready? What O crowned Anita Bryant their state beauty queen? Jimmy?
Oregon?
And now, wrong answer. John, you get a shot at it. What O crowned Anita Bryant their state beauty queen in 1958?
Oklahoma?
Correct. Oklahoma is right. Guess as good as a mile. Okay. John, where to?
V, Bill.
And if John gets it, he will have connected top to bottom and won the game. Of course, Cindy and Jimmy won a block. Here comes the question. Everybody ready? What V is show business's legendary... John.
Variety.
Trade paper. Ah. Variety is right, John. You won. Wow. Oh, good going, John. Boy, that was something, John. You came up there with that answer. Trade paper was legendary trade paper was what I had left. You didn't need it. So it's all tied up. John has won a game. Cindy and Jimmy have won a game. Each side has $500. The winner of this one is going on to play Gold Rush for $5,000. Okay, we're ready to start a new one. Clear the board. It's cleared, and, well, we'll clear it again. How do you like those little things? Like a pinball machine. We're going to start this one with a letter P, which you see up there. Okay, question one, deciding game. What P is the ranch where... Yes, John?
Ponderosa.
Where Hop Sing did the cooking, Ponderosa is the answer. Oh, boy. Watch it, Jimmy and Cindy. John's on a roll again. Where to, John?
W, please, Bill.
Letter W. Question coming. What W does Matilda do in a... John?
Waltz.
In Australia's national song, waltz is the answer. Where, John?
U, please, Bill.
Letter U. Cindy and Jimmy try to interrupt. Question. What U is Sir Thomas More's imaginary... John?
Utopia.
Ideal Island Utopia is the answer. John?
Yes, Bill.
If he gets it, it's the game, the match, and a chance at $5,000 more. Everybody ready? Question coming. What S is Pat Harrington's one day at a time role? Okay, no one want to take a chance. Schneider. We stay with S. And again, it can be the match and game for John. Cindy and Jimmy to block. Question. Big one. What S is a large beer glass or John?
Stein.
No. I repeat it in its entirety for Jimmy or Cindy. As soon as you think you know Jimmy, raise your hand. What S is a large beer glass or a sailing ship?
Sloop.
No.
Schooner.
Schooner. Schooner. John, you were saved on that one.
I've drunk enough beer, I should have known that.
John has drunk a lot of beer and sailed in a lot of ships, I guess. All right, we stay with the S, and we're still at that spot. It's match and game spot for John. Question coming. Everybody ready? What S is the stone creature that guards the pyramids? John, for the game.
Sphinx.
Right, you've got it. Okay, good game. Congratulations,
wow.
John. Good. Boy, that was a good game. You had all those reverses and came back to do it. So, it's another $500. That's $1,000. You now have won $31,000 in all. Jimmy and Cindy, you take with you $500 and our thanks for being with us and playing Rockbusters. Thanks, Cindy. Thank you, Jimmy. Give John a chance to go to our Gold Rush board in just a moment and win $5,000 more. But right now, if you watch this,
we can rebuild.
I was just counting up five times you've been there, John, so far. Well, let's hope you do it again. You're a good contestant and a good player, and now you've won your sixth game. It's your sixth game. You have 31,000 going for you, and we're going to give you a chance now to win 5,000 more on Gold Rush and make it 36,000. Come on over here and do just that. Wait a minute. Get ready. Okay. Little thing John and I started the first time up here, and keep it up. All right, we're ready now to play Gold Rush. For those of you at home who might be new to us or haven't watched us for a while, I'll explain it to you. Win the big money, you start at the left side and you make a path connecting the gold to the gold. If you make the connection, you win $5,000 more. If you miss or pass, a block goes up and you have to work your way around it. Some of the questions are harder than others. The idea is to find the path and don't get stuck too much in one place. Get around and make that connection. You have 60 seconds. Keep going until time runs out. Okay. Put 60 seconds up. Harry's alongside of John again. Fine-looking pair there, John. I wish you luck. And we will begin the clock when you tell me where you would like to start. Here we go.
M.P.
The Muppets Swine Lady.
Miss Piggy.
Correct.
T.B.
Star of Hitchcock's Lifeboat.
Tallulah Bankhead.
Right.
G.H.
Starred as Moss Hart.
Past. A.W.T.E.W.
Shakespeare play with an optimistic title.
All's well that ends well.
Right.
I hope it does. W.S.
Played Captain Kirk.
William Shatner.
Right.
T.N.
Substitute conductor on The Tonight Show.
Tommy Newsom.
You did it again. Congratulations, John. Okay. Good going. Very good player, John. How do you like that? How much time do you have? 20 seconds again. That's the second time, John, that you've been up there with 20. You know, John is getting so good at this, I think in his head he knows about how much time he has. Did you notice how he teased me and laid that Tommy Newsom in there? That was beautiful. $36,000. You are still eligible. Go on over there, relax, get your breath. We're going to give you a chance to meet a couple of new players. All right. Hey, we got two nice ladies coming in here. Say hello to you. Hi, Gully. It's a mother and daughter team. Yes. Hi, ladies.
Hi.
Hello there. Faith, you're the daughter, I see.
Mm-hmm.
How are you, Faith?
I'm okay.
Tell us about you.
I'm a junior at Hollywood High School, uh-huh. And I'm captain of the JV cheerleading squad there. Rah.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, boy, we're happy to have you with us. Norma?
Thank you.
Norma Lipton, the mother. I don't know if I said the Liptons. Tell us about you, Norma.
I've been married for 33 happy years,
uh-huh.
To one man also.
Good, good.
I have four sons, one lovely daughter, two lovely daughters-in-law, and I'm an assistant manager at a leading department store.
Welcome, Norma. Happy
Thank
to
you.
Have you. You met John, I know. You all
I
know
certainly
each other.
Have. Good luck, John. That was
Yay!
Fabulous. Fabulous.
Okay, we're going to start our game right now. Play the match consists of two games. Winner of each winner of a game gets $500. First one who wins two games and gets 1,000 goes up for the Gold Rush. Actually, it consists of three games if we get a tie in there. Okay, we're all ready to begin this one. Going to start with the letter B. And you know, Faith and Norma, the answer begins with a B.
Mm-hmm.
You two both have your hands on the button. I see you're ready to go. As soon as you think you know the answer, hit the button. Okay, question coming. Here's question one. What B is Brussels the capital of? John?
Belgium.
Of course, and John has the first one. Red's going to make a connection from bottom to top or top to bottom. Time's run out on us, at least for the moment. We'll be back. Don't you go away. But right now, we have to... We would like to see you. I mean, if you don't want to, it's all right with me.
There's a new...
John, I was remiss in your last game where you won the $5,000. I did not give the right answer to the one question you missed. And I, for you, but for the folks at home who might be testing themselves, G.H. Starred as Moss Hart. That was George Hamilton in the motion picture about the life of Moss Hart. Pretty good picture, too. A lot of Moss Hart music in it, and it's darn good music, I tell you. Hey, thank you, Faith and Norman. Thank
Bye-bye.
You, John, for being well. You're going to be back again.
Yeah.
We're going to pick it up tomorrow at this same place. We would like to have you along. Goodbye.
This is Bob Hilton speaking for our Blockbusters, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.